It's been a crazy holiday and I took a nap this afternoon. And I dreamt that I was in a station wagon with a bunch of random people trying to figure out where the Rock and Roll Hall induction was. This is a little bit like getting an Oscar for a screenplay you haven't finished writing yet, but for me, it's just a huge thrill, and it's a huge honor, but it's definitely also a very big honor for me to get to be inducted alongside one of the people I admire most on this planet, and that's Willie Nelson. I'm from a really small town called Kent, Missouri, and tonight, my town has like three stoplights, it's got one high school, and it has one movie theater, and my town is there tonight with my mom and my dad. Thank you to the rest of my family who traveled very long to get here tonight. Mom and Dad, thank you so much for raising me the way you did. Thank you for loving music and for playing everything from Stan Kenton to Duke Ellington to Burt Bacharach to Dionne Warwick to Jen Taylor to Carole King to Stevie Wonder to Elton John. I love you. And thank you for all the years of unconditional love and for piano lessons. I have to say, I'm one of the most blessed people I know that I get to be mom to Wyatt and Levi, my two sons. Given me, and I will say I was very happy with whatever God gave me, but I'm so happy to be raising boys. Anyway, there is nothing that can compare to the joy and love you've given my life, and nothing I do means anything without you guys. I had a beautiful thank you speech, but it came in around 7.5 hours. So I'm just going to say kind of a brief thank you that encompasses a lot of people. The people that started out with me 30 years ago are still here. They are my manager, my business manager, my lawyer, my agent. I mean, all of these people have stuck with me through the whole journey. I always say that all of my friends are on my payroll, and it's kind of true. And I always say, you know, if anybody leaves me, I'll have to have them killed. They know where all the bodies are buried. But I want to say, I had the same manager from the very beginning. His name is Scooter Weintraub. And he's a wonderful person, and he's always put what was best for me before money. And that just speaks volumes. I want to thank Pam also, who basically manages Scooter. Musicians and the crew that have traveled with me for the last 36 years, you are family. We have been through cancer together, we've been through raising babies, we've been through divorces, we've lost people along the way, and that's what music has brought me. It's been the most incredible journey. When I think about the years playing music and my journey, I could not have dreamed my life. When I was growing up, our popularity wasn't based on likes. It was based on who had the best record collection and who threw the best parties when their parents were out of town. Because there were no computers, no internet, no cell phones, there was Rolling Stone magazine and Green magazine. That's where you found the mythical glimpses into rock star. There was American Bandstand, Soul Train, and Midnight Special, where you would catch your favorite artists playing their latest hits. I was a kid who dreamed rock and roll, poured over album covers. I knew every name of every musician on every album cover, and I found my identity in the lyrics from the songs that I'm sure were written for me. Like, I'm sure Jen Taylor wrote Iron Rain about me and for me. Stevie Nicks, honestly, could not
be who I am
without her. And I felt certain as a kid that because I could twirl a baton and had a really long wavy blonde hair, that we were probably related somehow. I found my command of words through her imagery and her melodies. I also found myself in the greats like Tina Turner and Bonnie Raitt and Nancy Wilson, who with their ability to front a band with electric guitars showed me the way. I sang Linda Ronstadt songs into a curling iron like all the greats before me. I found a way out poetry. And there have been so many musicians who have brought me here. Most of them are actually in the Roll Call already. Music's been a way out of my hometown and into a world of possibility. In 1976, you guys, when I was 14, my best friend Jovette's mom drove us, me and six little girls, to the Mid-South Coliseum in Memphis, Tennessee to see Peter Frampton. The way up in the nosebleed section, we managed to crawl all the way down to the floor. I smelled weed for the first time. I love tens of thousands of strangers to do you feel like I do. And who doesn't dream of that being your life after you've experienced it? That was a pivotal moment for me in understanding what Carlos Santana says about music changing the molecules. How music can connect a whole room full of strangers through a cosmic journey that cannot be without a collective experience. My kids always say, Mom, you know you were born in the 1870s. And I did go before technology became a connector and a divider and an anesthetizer and a distractor and a facilitator. I grew up before 24-hour news, before drug companies could advertise on TV, that's how old I am. I grew up with Walter Cronkite and the nightly news, and until 1975, when I was 13 years old, each evening we watched the caskets come off the planes, and we read the names scrolled across the TV of those lost and missing in Vietnam. The music from that time reflected what was happening in the world. It gave voice to everyone who was experiencing this, particularly the younger generation. And those songs got played on the radio, Marvin Gaye, Buffalo Springfield, Creedence Clearwater. That's what the best music does. It entertains us, but it also makes us feel. In my case, music took me to Japan, it took me to South America, it took me to Berlin before the wall fell. It took me to Russia, and it even took me to Israel. It is unimaginable. With as many words as all I want to do, we have people who don't even speak English as a second language trying to capture every word. It's a musical, music is a universal gift that we all share, and seeing those places definitely gave me perspective to how good we have it here in America. He said, if you love what you do, you will never work a day in your life. Yes, for me there have been ups and downs along this journey, but mine is a story of infinite possibility for any young person setting out on the musical journey. I love the work. Thank you guys.
It is my great honor and privilege, though I'm saying it's one of the proudest moments of my life, to welcome DJ Cool Herc into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Let me rock this all I wanna do. Let me rock this all I wanna do. Let me rock this all I wanna do.
our beloved George in three of his biggest songs, Carry On The Word from Adam Levine. And to kick things off, we go.
Thank you.
It's been so long, but it seems like it was only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? I was your new love. I hope it's doing fine. Heard you told him you'd love him until the end of time. Now that's the same thing you told me. Seems like just the other day. Ain't it funny how time slips away?
Appreciating my music. Thank you so much. Hall of Fame. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Why do I let myself win? road again. you must see the
Yeah.